Hello and welcome to SprutCAM Tutorials, brought to you by SprutCAM America. In this tutorial, I'm going to show some of the differences between SprutCAM 7 and the new SprutCAM 8. SprutCAM 8 is on the top of my screen, and SprutCAM 7 is on the bottom. First thing I'm going to do is import a model into both versions of the software. So I'm going to go to File, in SprutCAM 7, I'm going to File, Import, going to find SprutCAM 7 IGIS file, and click Open. Click OK, and we have a solid model that says SprutCAM 7. Now, I'm going to do the same thing in SprutCAM 8, but I'm going to go to Project, Import, find my SprutCAM 8 IGIS file, and click Open. Click OK, and there is our solid model of SprutCAM 8. Two slightly different ways of going about to do the same thing, but you can see both things can be achieved. Now, let's go over some of the more glaring differences. You can see a lot of differences in the layout of the icons. In SprutCAM 8, some of these icons, like the work positioning icon in SprutCAM 7, in SprutCAM 8 is actually a drop-down. The geometrical activation icons right here, which is like, if you hover over this one, you'll see this one's called Geometry Model Visibility. That is essentially the same, except for on the bot, it's not on the bottom anymore, it's on the top. We also have some differences in where the calipers and the part compare icon are. They're over here. Also a difference is the coordinate system selection window. It's a little different. It's got some bigger icons around it instead of these little guys, a little easier to deal with. One icon that you probably don't deal with very much in SprutCAM 7 is the groups icon. This gets turned on a little bit more frequently in SprutCAM 8 and may cause you to not be able to select edges. So see how I have an edge selection here? Depending on the group that is selected, you may not be able to select that edge. There's a lot of different dependings on there, but that's one thing you'll want to check. Also, you'll see over here the snap tos. Now, the snap tos won't show up in SprutCAM 8 unless you're actually in 2D geometry. Then you get all the snap tos showing up. One other big difference is this icon right here, which is, we hover over it, they call it Smart Snap, is here, so it's separate from these. So you may not remember to turn it on because it is separate from those in SprutCAM 8. Go back to the Model tab. You'll notice a couple of different things here. Compared to the Model tab in SprutCAM 7, you'll see different levels, and you'll see 2D geometry with some global CS workpiece and fixtures. On here, you see the different levels: workpiece, fixtures, 2D geometry, global, but then they also allow you to select different planes. So if you're drawing in 2D geometry, normally the only plane that you can draw in is the global CS plane on SprutCAM 7. But in SprutCAM 8, you can select XY plane. In SprutCAM 7, there is no XY plane here because when you look in the global CS, that's all you get. Now in SprutCAM 8, if you look in global CS and drop it down, there's XYZ those are different planes that you can actually draw in. So let's say we want to draw in our global CS plane in 2D geometry. We can just draw a line. Now, if we want to, we can switch to, let's say, YZ plane. Now you'll notice this becomes inactive, and we can draw a line in a completely different plane, which would be over here. Okay, so we have a line in a totally different plane now. Before, you would have to actually make different coordinate systems and then toggle between them. Now you can just pick the different planes. And then when you go back to Model tab, you can find your different geometry inside the plane, the different plane that you selected. So if this is the plane that I selected, the different geometry will be in there once you save it. And then you can eliminate it or alter it later. So that's a little something different. Let's go back to 2D geometry and undo everything we have done. We undid that. Now we have to go to Global CS and we can effectively delete some of these other lines. Okay. In the Model tab, it is very similar to select your coordinate, your origin. You do it essentially the same way as you do it in SprutCAM 7. So let's do in SprutCAM 7, let's do it where we're selecting our Model tab, and we're going to select part, and then select the IDIS file, select our transform function, locate 0, middle max, apply. Close, and we're right in the center of our SprutCAM 7. Should be pretty similar in SprutCAM 8. Part, SprutCAM 8, transform functions, locate 0, apply. Close. Still right in the center. The one thing you may notice is that when we do this in SprutCAM 7, you do get like an outline, but it's not as sharp as in SprutCAM 8. One thing you'll notice a lot with the graphics as far as SprutCAM 8, they are sharper because this is a true 64-bit system. SprutCAM 7 was just running in a 64-bit computer in 32-bit mode. So when we do the same thing with SprutCAM 8, locate 0, you get a little sharper view of where that's going to end up. But essentially those two operations are the same. All right, other changes that may be interesting. The biggest ones are, of course, that the different icons are in different areas. Those are the biggest changes that you're going to see. Now, in the Machining tab, we're going to look at Create in SprutCAM 8. And let's just click on the Create button, and this window will pop up. In roughing, there's quite a few less roughing operations. Let's do the same thing down here and click Create. There seems to be, let's see. Oh. Home Machining 5D is now, and Home Machining have been combined. So in SprutCAM 7, there's two of these. In SprutCAM 8, there is only hole machining. No more hole machining 5D. Well, let's go look at the finishing. Rotary machining still there. 3D contouring still there. We have 5D contouring is still there. Most things are there. This 2.5D chamfer machining, that is different. Let's see, jet cutting is still there. We have some optimized surface, some optimized planes and complex operations. Drive is still there. Flatland finishing is still there, and waterline. Most of them are there. I think the only real difference is this 2D. 2.5D chamfer machining. That's our big difference there. I don't get too much into rest machining. We can look at some of the differences. There's just no, the 2.5D chamfer machining used to be in rest machining. Now it's in finishing on SprutCAM 8. And there is no 2.5D flatland. That's gone. So those are a few differences. Some of these graphics are a little better in 8 than they are in 7. We can look at some of these graphics a little different. Let's go to rest machining, finishing, waterline. They're very similar, but they just seem a little smoother in 8. Now, one of the big changes between SprutCAM 7 and SprutCAM 8 is 2D contouring has changed quite dramatically. So let's look at that. Let's go and create a finishing 2D contouring operation. And I'm going to go to job assignment, and I'm going to pick that edge and click curve. Now we're going to do the same thing down here. We're going to pick create a finishing 2D contour, pick that edge, go to job assignment and click curve. Okay, so right away you'll tell there's a little differences in the icons that we have going here. Now in SprutCAM 7 you were able to curve. Some of the later versions of SprutCAM 7, you could curve the path. You can still do that in SprutCAM 8. However, you can curve the path, and you can also curve a different path. You can change that arc to a straight line if you would like. Instead, you can use this as an entry cut. You can do a complex straight line. There's a lot more flexibility into what you can do. It'll tell you, you know, your degrees. You can keep moving that out. That. Move another one. Multi-select. There's a lot of different things you can do with 2D contouring in SprutCAM 8 that you could not do in SprutCAM 7. Essentially, in SprutCAM 7, you had the ability to do this, which was nice, but now it's becoming even more functional. Use that as an entry cut. Turn that into a line. You have another line there. A lot of different things you can do. You can double click it. If you didn't want it, you just take it off altogether. Take that off. None. Choose lead in, lead out, lead shape, length, angle, item. There's a lot of different things you can do there. So that is really one of the biggest changes. Now let's also look at creating a roughing hole machining operation in 8. So once we've done that, we've created a roughing hole machining, I'm just going to open up the parameter screen. You're going to see also in SprutCAM 8, you can adjust the screens. You could not do that in SprutCAM 7. Strategy is looking different. Feeds and speeds. This is where in before you could do thread milling. Now you can just do that thread milling and it'll fill up the box with all the things that you need to do for thread milling. Before, let's just move this up. In SprutCAM 7, we could go roughing, hole machining, but you would have to do hole machining 5D in order to get some of these same functionalities. So hole machining and hole machining 5D have been grouped together. You cannot change the screen here, but you can see strategy, you pick thread milling. It's a little different than it looks like in 8. But regardless, it is the entire strategy has been changed to some degree to include both things in one. Those are the biggest changes that you're going to notice. In the simulation tab, as in SprutCAM 7, some things that some people just don't realize are there are the solid, the voxel 3D, and voxel 5D. It's the same thing in SprutCAM 8. Voxel 5D is going to give you a very nice simulation usually, comparatively speaking to the rest. Simulation kernel is otherwise very close to the same. So essentially those are the main big differences between SprutCAM 7 and SprutCAM 8. The obvious and largest differences being the icon selections are in here. One other thing, you can pin these different areas open in case you like to use one more than the other. I usually pin control. By double clicking on it, you can pin project if you'd want it to stay open. That way, if you go to control, in a little bit it comes back to project. I pin control usually, so if you go to project, do what you need, it snaps back to control. So those are going to be the biggest differences that you'll notice between SprutCAM 8 and SprutCAM 7. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks.